हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज नवर्षा पिपाड़ा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज बीकानेर. इन यस्टरडेज क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट सम ऑफ द फ्लो कंट्रोल मैकेनिज्म्स फॉर नॉइजलेस चैनल एंड फॉर नॉइजी. वी हैव डिवाइडेड द चैनल इंटू टू पार्ट्स. फर्स्ट वन इज नॉइजलेस चैनल एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज नॉइजी चैनल. So after that we studied about the simplex protocol and what are the problems in stop and wait ARQ protocol. In stop and wait ARQ we were taking only one frame in a round trip time. Only one frame was being transferred from sender to receiver in a particular round trip time. So that's why we were not able to optimize the bandwidth of the channel. So in our next protocol we will utilize the channel up to some extent. So we will send more than one frame simultaneously through the channel so that we can achieve the maximum efficiency of the channel. Okay, so next is pipelining. We have already discussed this. Okay, so the next protocol is go back n automatic repeat request. In go back n protocol we send more than one frames and the number of frames are we decide with via some parameters we'll discuss. So in go back n basically it is based upon the one thing that whenever you are transmitting the data rather than getting acknowledgement for each and every frame, you collect the frame and the combination of frame, you create a window. We can create a window and in that particular window we have more than one frames. Then we transfer the frames based upon that window and we can get the acknowledgement of the whole window. Instead of taking acknowledgement for each and every frame, we can take the acknowledgement for the whole window so that the network traffic can be reduced. When we take for each and every frame, if you are taking acknowledgement, then definitely there will be more network traffic. So to reduce this, we are in go back n protocol. We take only for the combination of frames, we take the acknowledgement. Okay, so in this protocol we can send several frames before receiving acknowledgement. We keep a copy of these frames until the acknowledgement arrives. So we keep all the copies in likewise in stop and wait protocol. We keep all the acknowledgements, we keep all the frames, copy of all the frames until we get the acknowledgement for that particular frame. If the header of the frame allows m bits for the sequence number, the sequence numbers range from 2 power m minus 1. So if m is equal to 4, so if you are taking 4 bits for sequence number, then it can be from 0 to 15. So we can also repeat the sequence number 0, 1, 2, 3 up to so on 15. Then again we can repeat from 0, 1, 2 and so on. In go back n protocol, the sequence numbers are modulo 2 power m, where m is the size of the sequence number field in the bits. Okay, one concept we use here is sliding window. Sliding window is an abstract concept that defines the range of sequence numbers that is the concern of the sender and the receiver. See, we have a 0 to 15. We have we can take the values from 0 to 15 for sequence number, but for a particular window, how many frames we can take simultaneously in a window, we have to decide it. So the send window is an abstract concept defining an imaginary box of 2 power m minus 1, where three variables are there, sf, sn and s size. We'll see it later. The send window can slide one or more slots when a valid acknowledgement arrives. The receive window is an abstract concept defining an imaginary box of size 1. So the window size for the receiver is only one with a single variable rn. The window slides when a correct frame has arrived and sliding occurs one slot at a time. So whenever the receiver correctly receives a frame, it will slide with one slot. ओके दिस इज द सेंडर विंडो. ओके सी दीज आर द फ्रेम्स वेट These are the frames we have received for which we have received the acknowledgement. These are the frame which are in processing with they sent, but we have not received acknowledgement. So we are not confirmed whether these frames has been received by the receiver or not. Okay, so so this is SF send window. SN is the send window, next frame to send. So these are the frames we will send in the next slot. The sender window size is 2^m-1. So here we have taken 4, so 2^4 is 16, 16 minus 1 is 15, so from 0 to 14 we are taking. Okay, sender window, this is the sender window, so this one is the receiver window. This is the receiver window, send window, okay, not receiver window. This is the sender window after sliding. When we have received acknowledgement for 0, 1 and 2, again the window will slide. So, it will be from starting from 3, like this. So, left hand side part will denote the frames which have already acknowledged. And the middle one is the frames which are in process. And the right hand side window tells you about the frames that has not yet been sent. Okay, next is receiver window. The size of the receiver window is only 1. So the left hand side part tells you about the frames already received and acknowledged. And the next RN is the parameter which the frame which is in process. Or you can say the next frame expected by the receiver. Okay, so, and the right hand side part tells you about the frames that cannot be received until the window slides. Okay. This is the designing of go back and ARQ. See here, we are sending more than one frames in a particular round trip time. More than one windows we are sending and we are getting the acknowledgement here. Okay, next we will see why we are taking window size less than 2^m, why we are not taking window size equal to 2^m. As we have sequence numbers from 0 to 2^m, but we are taking it less than 2^m. So first we will see if we are taking less than 2^m. So this is the scenario for window size less than 2^m. So windows are, so we have sequence bits, let's suppose sequence m is equal to 2, so we have sequence numbers 4 and we are taking less than 2^m, so 0, 1, 2, 3 we are taking. First we will send the frame 0 and then the acknowledgement lost, frame 1, 2 and okay, so we will send up to frame 2 because we have window size is 2. Window size is 3, so we can send 0, 1, 2 before receiving the acknowledgement. After that, the timeout will occur here. So the sender will again send frame number 0. So this receiver has already received frame 0, 1 and 2. So the frame 0 which the sender has previously sent, again the sender will send the same frame. But what receiver is expecting? Receiver is expecting the frame number 3. Okay, so receiver will not accept it and receiver will discard this. Okay, again when if we take window size as 2^m, so we will take 0, 1, 2, 3 inside the window and then we can send frame number 0, 1, 2 and 3 simultaneously and then after that the timer will time out at this point and then again we have not received acknowledgement, again the sender sends the frame number 0. Okay, so sender is sending this previous frame 0, but receiver is expecting this frame 0. So, but receiver will, the identification is same. So, what receiver will do? Receiver will accept the frame as and it will consider this as the next frame number, this one. So, this is wrong. Why this happens? Because we have taken the sender, the window size as equal to 2^m. Okay, when it was less than 2^m, the sender cannot slide the window until acknowledgement of all the frames arrives. So this is the reason why we are taking window size less than 2^m. Okay, in go back and ARQ, the size of the sender window must be less than 2^m. The size of the receiver window is always 1. This is 2^m. Stop and wait ARQ is a special case of go back n in which the size of the sender window is 1. Stop and wait is the difference. The sender window is 1. That is the only difference between stop and wait and go back n. This is the flow diagram of go back and ARQ. So we will see. Okay. So see, this is SF and SN. At the starting, SF and SN are same. So SF is nothing but the frame we are sending. The acknowledgement, we have received the acknowledgement. The frame is in process. Okay. So we have taken the from 0 to 6 we have taken. So we have taken 7 as window size. So initially 0 to 6. So initially frame 0 will be sent and ACK 1 will arrive. Then frame 1 will send. So ACK 2 is lost. Again we will send frame 2 before taking the ACK, before waiting for the ACK. Frame 3 we have sent. Okay, and so ACK 2 is not yet come, but ACK 3 will come and ACK 4 will come. So this ACK is lost. So what sender will do, see here, the sender has stopped the timer. So frame 0, 1, 2, 3 has been sent. So see, the sliding will occur only when we have received the acknowledgement. So for frame 0, we have received the acknowledgement. Okay, so this will slide only one slot. For 1-2 we have not yet received the acknowledgement, so this window will not slide. Okay, so see here what we are taking, ACK3, we have received ACK3. So as the sender know, ACK3 can only come. See, go back and protocol, receiver only accept in order frames. So if receiver is expecting for frame number 2 and we are sending 3, this will simply discard it. So if we are getting ACK of 3 and ACK 4, that means ACK 2, this is understandable for the sender that ACK 2 has been already arrived to the receiver. So there is no need to wait for ACK 2. So simply this window will slide. So this is how we are achieving the efficiency of the network. We are sending a more than one frame without waiting for the acknowledgement. Okay, so this is go back and protocol. So next we will see selective repeat, automatic repeat request. So what is selective repeat? See, in go back and what is the problem? Let's suppose if this frame 2, if this frame number, this frame is lost. Okay, so receiver will not okay, let's suppose this frame number 1 is lost. Okay, if this frame number 1 is lost, so receiver will not accept frame number 2 and frame number 3. It will discard. So what sender has will do, whenever the timer expires, the sender will again send the frame number 1, 2, and 3 or if it has already sent 4, 5, 6, 7, then again it has to send 4, 5, 6, 7, means it has to send the whole window. So what will happen, again the sender has to send all the frames starting from that particular frame. So this is the problem of go back and protocol. So for this purpose we use selective repeat protocol. Selective repeat, automatic repeat request. Go back n is very efficient for a noisy link. In a noisy link, a frame has a higher probability of damage, which means the resending of multiple frames. Resending uses up the bandwidth and slows down the transmission. For noisy links, there is another mechanism that does not resend n frames. When just one frame is damaged, only one frame is resent. So go back and first, the size of the sender window is much smaller in a selective repeat, which is the sender size is 2^m-1. So selective repeat it is. Okay, so in selective repeat, the size of the sender window is 2 power m minus 1 and the receiver window is also 2 power m minus 1. Okay, so this is the sender window. These are the frames which have already acknowledged. These are the frames sent but not acknowledged, and these are the frames which are not yet sent. So size is equal to 2 power m minus 1. So receiver window also has the size of 2 power m minus 1. Here what we are doing is, here the receiver accepts the out of order frames also, and whenever all the frames has been collected, receiver will sort all the frames, and then it will and then those frames will be sent to the upper layer. So once the receiver is here complex, but error is less. Receiver has to apply sorting mechanism for all the received frames, and when all the when the frames of the whole window comes, then receiver will sort the frames and then it will send to the higher layers. Because it is accepting out of order frames, so whenever there is a loss of a frame, receiver can accept the next frame, and so sender need not to resend all the frames again and again. This is the design of selective repeat ARQ. Okay, selective repeat ARQ window size. So why we are taking window size as 2 power m minus 1? See, we are sending frame 0, and let's suppose ACK is lost, frame 1 ACK is lost. Again we are sending frame number 0. So what receiver will do, receiver is expecting for frame number 2, so this frame 0 will be discarded. Okay, let's suppose if window size is greater than 2 power m minus 1, so we are taking 0, 1, 2 as the window size. So frame 0 is lost, frame 1 is lost, frame 2 is lost. So what sender will do, after the timeout, sender will again send the frame number 0, because it is assumed by the sender that the frame 0 has not been received by the receiver, or there is some damage in the channel. So likewise this erroneously we have accepted the frame number 0. Here we were expecting receiver was expecting frame number 2. So frame number 2, if the sender sends frame number 0, it will be discarded. Here the receiver is already expecting for frame number 0, so this will be taken. In selective repeat ARQ, size of the sender and the receiver window must be at most 1/2 of 2 power m. Okay, so before the delivery, this is the diagram of selective repeat ARQ, and after delivery of the frame, the window will slide. This is the flow diagram of selective repeat. Okay, let's suppose we have taken window size as 4. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So this frame 0 is sent and ACK 1 arrives. Again frame 1 is sent but it is lost. Again frame 2 is sent, frame 3 is sent. So receiver will receive frame 2 and frame 3. And after the timeout, only that frame 1 is resent, and then receiver will send the ACK for 4. Okay, so here what one thing we can do is we can send the negative acknowledgement. Whenever receiver receives a out of order frame, it will send a negative acknowledgement of the sequence which has not been received. So if the receiver is getting frame number 2, it will send a negative acknowledgement to the sender that I have not received frame 1 yet. So sender will again resend the frame number 1, not frame number 2 and 3. Okay, again after sending the frame number 1, again ACK 4 will, receiver will send the ACK 4, and then you can transfer it. Okay, next we have one more concept known as piggybacking. So in piggybacking, what we are till right now, what we were doing is we were only sending the data in one direction, unidirectional data was being transmitted. But ACK and negative acknowledgement we are transmitting. So what we can do is we can transfer the data in both the directions simultaneously, and ACK and data can combine, and then we can transfer them. So all the three protocols we discussed in this section are unidirectional. Data frames flow in one direction and ACK flows in another direction. In real life, data frames are normally flowing in both the directions. So from node A to node B and B to A. So in real time applications, data flows in both the direction, not in one direction. This means that the control information also needs to flow in both the directions. A technique which is known as piggybacking is used to improve the efficiency of the bidirectional protocols. When a frame is carrying data from A to B, it can carry the frame as well as ACK. So it can also contain the carry the control information. That control information means ACK, negative ACK, like that. So when a frame is carrying data from B to A, it can also carry control information about the arrived frames from A, that is ACK. This is the designing of piggybacking in GoBack and ARQ. Okay, so like this, see, we have sending the data, and from this direction data and ACK data, this is ACK. Okay, some other information, and likewise we can also transfer from the other direction. So okay, thank you so much.